The views and opinions expressed in this podcast do not necessarily reflect on anyone other than the host or his respective guest. Some know him as the defender of common sense. Others simply know him as that South African asshole on YouTube. For the purpose of this podcast, we simply refer to him as Ronaldo. Regardless of what you might call him, get ready to be slapped in the face with a little known thing called common sense. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the RG Show.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Ronaldo here, and welcome to the RG Show. This is podcast number 003. Now, before I get into the crux of this podcast, I would like to ask a favor of you. If you are watching this on YouTube, please do me a favor and click on the description and follow the SoundCloud and iTunes link. And make sure that you follow me on SoundCloud and that you subscribe to me on iTunes. And then also leave a positive rating on iTunes, because this allows me to possibly feature in the news and noteworthy section, which means that I'll get a lot more exposure than what I currently am on iTunes. So I'd really appreciate that. All right, so with that being said, this podcast is going to focus on the double standards of racism in South Africa. Now, needless to say, all racism is wrong, and I treat white racists exactly the same as I treat black racists, which is with no respect at all. But clearly, this isn't the case for some people in South Africa, and especially to an extent, the media. Now, I'd like to cite a few examples of recent racist events in this country, and let me know if you can see a pattern forming. First on the list is Penny Sparrow. Now, as most of you know, she called black people monkeys. Now, needless to say, that is clearly racist. She trended on Twitter and social media for weeks. All media houses covered it, and she was found guilty in a court of law. Next up, we've got Velepi Khumalo. He said that white people deserve to be killed like the Jews. It didn't trend on social media as much. Well, in actual fact, it trended for a little bit and it died down very quickly. Some media houses covered it and there was no court action. Next up, we've got Matthew Tionizan, called black people the K-word. Also clearly racist, trended for weeks, all media houses covered it, was given community service and had to publicly apologize to the people that he offended. Next up, we've got Ntokozo Kwabe. He didn't give a waitress a tip because she was white. Clearly a racist act. Didn't trend on social media. Some media houses covered it and there was no court action. Next up, Andre Slade. He refused to give accommodation to black people at his bed and breakfast and called them non-human. Clearly a racist act. Trended on social media for weeks. All media houses covered it. And the EDTA MEC investigated the matter and it's still waiting an outcome. Next up, we've got Julius Malema. Said white people should be killed. Didn't trend on social media and some media houses covered it, but there's also no court action taken. Next on the list, Rian Lucas. Celebrated the death of someone because they were white. And obviously, as you know, this white individual was Joost van der Westhuizen. It didn't trend on social media. Some media houses covered it, and so far there's no court action. So those are the examples that I've given you. And if you had to take a careful look at it and focus on the race of the person that I mentioned and what type of reaction and response and coverage they got, you'll find that the media and social media was a lot harsher on white racists than it was on black racists. Now, as I said earlier in this video, I treat all racists equally. They are the cancer of this country and they deserve to be treated like outcasts. Majority of people in this country just want to live their lives peacefully and coexist with one another. Now, with that being said, there's one thing that I would like to talk about specifically, and that is a phenomenon known as Black Twitter. And I label it as Black Twitter because that is what they label it themselves. It's a collection of black people that are on Twitter, and it's literally millions of people. Now, the problem I have with Black Twitter is that Black Twitter is very selective when it comes to when they decide to expose racism. And trust me, when they expose it, those people trend for days on social media, and then the media picks it up and it becomes a massive story. And I can respect that. The problem, however, is that they, like I said, are very selective when it comes to the racism that they call out. If it's a white individual that does something racist, then it trends for days. However, if it's a black individual that says something racist, then nothing is being said. Their silence is deafening. So clearly black Twitter has double standards when it comes to white on black racism versus black on white racism. And that's very unfortunate, especially in the current South Africa that we live in. Now, to end off this section on black Twitter, I just want to say the following. I find it quite ironic that when black Twitter exposes these white racists, you'll often find that the things they say about this racist is racist. You'll find that they will go, white people this, or yes, they, or they will use terms that basically makes them racists. And that's basically all I'm going to say on black Twitter. Now, the next big issue I have when it comes to racism in this country is how the media outlets handle it. There's absolutely no doubt that news coverage features white racism a lot more than black racism. And if you look at that list of names that I gave earlier, you'll find that it was equally spread between white and black people. Yet white people featured more prevalently than black people when it came to racism. And you just need to Google this and you'll find what I'm talking about. As an example, there was that white farmer that decided to give the black pregnant lady a lift to the nearest clinic. There was no space on his front seat. He offered to let her sit in the back seat, and she declined because she wanted to sit on the back of the buggy because it was hot, according to her. I also can't blame her because it was a stranger and she might have felt more comfortable on the back of the buggy. The problem, however, is that there was a scale on the back of the buggy which weighs livestock, but it looks like a cage. So she got on the back of the buggy, she put herself in that cage, and somebody took a picture of it. Needless to say, that picture went viral across South Africa, and all media houses picked up on it and shared it without actually knowing exactly what happened. Now, granted, when you look at that image, you can sort of understand why that can be considered racist. However, once the person was found, the black lady, and her side of the story was told, not a lot of media houses covered that aspect of it. So all of them covered the fact that this took place and shared the photo, but not all of them followed up and actually reported on what went down, which once again shows hypocrisy. Now, if you look at what that farmer went through and actually ended up being innocent versus what somebody like, let's say, Julius Malema went through for making a racist and hateful statement by saying that white people should be killed. If you compare those two with one another and how they trended on social media and how the media houses reported on it, then you can understand what I'm talking about when it comes to the hypocrisy on reporting on racism in this country. And I'm not trying to sell you this idea. It's there for everyone to see. It is fact. If you compare the amount of hatred and exposure that Penny Sparrow, Matthew Tiernison, Andre Slade, and this farmer went through versus Julius Malema and Tokozo Kwabe and Velepi Kumalo, then you can understand what I'm talking about. So I will recommend that you do a Google search on these people that I mentioned and just see how much media coverage there was for the white racists versus the amount of coverage that there was for the black racists. That's all I'm going to say, because the numbers speak for themselves and you can find out that information. I don't have to sell it to you. You can merely Google it and you'll understand what I'm talking about. Now, lastly, the thing that really perturbs me the most when it comes to these type of arguments is the excuse used by some right-wing black people that say that black people can't be racist. Now, I'm not even going to get suckered into this conversation because it's a lose-lose argument. If I debate this, then white privilege will be brought into the equation and once again it will be used as a weapon. Or I will be labeled as a racist because, you know, that's just once again an easy excuse to use. So all I will say is what the dictionary says on racism. Now, the dictionary defines racism as the belief that all members of each race possesses characteristics, abilities, or qualities specific to that race, especially so as to distinguish it as inferior or superior to another race or races. That's pretty clear. I'm not going to fall for the whole power argument or the fact that black people can't be racist because they've got no power or land or whatever. It has nothing to do with power. It has everything to do with your mind and how you see things and how you see different races. It's as simple as that. To end off this podcast, I just want to leave you with a final thought. And that thought is that it's truly unfortunate that we live in a South Africa where we fight racism selectively. Racism is racism, and true South Africans should fight all forms of it. The problem isn't white racism or black racism. The problem is racism. And that's basically all I've got to say. Thank you so much for listening to this podcast. I really do appreciate it. And let's continue this conversation in the comment section, because I will be active there. Also, be sure to give this podcast a thumbs up. And if you want to, go to the description, go to SoundCloud and iTunes and follow me on both. And especially on iTunes, be sure to give me a 5-star rating so that I can feature in the news and noteworthy section on iTunes. Also, be sure to share this podcast with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.
And that's a wrap for this week's show. Keep updated to this podcast by hitting the follow button. And if you've enjoyed this dose of common sense, then be sure to like, post, and share with everyone you know. Till later, cheers, and peace out.